Made in Canada by Daniel J. Towsey, April 18, 2008. The closed-minded know everything but see nothing. Before NAFTA, I could go to any retailer and I would have a really hard time to find anything that did not have a Made in Canada label. The only items that had a different label were beautiful artistic items and great Japanese electronics. Once upon a time, there was a lot of Canadian pride in our Canadian products. There was signs everywhere promoting by Made in Canada and little Canadian flags on Canadian products. Now when I go shopping, I cannot find anything Made in Canada. As a result of all the cheap Chinese products flooding all the new huge foreign retail store chains. Before NAFTA, we had lots of Canadian-owned national retail chains. Like Woolco, Woolworths, Towers, Byway, Kmart, Steinberg's, just to name few. All these are now gone. We only have a couple of surviving chains, like Zellers and Canadian Tire. They only survived because they now sell Chinese goods. I went to my local Walmart recently and saw a sign that said that Walmart is concerned about selling goods manufactured in Canada to help local employment and does so when it can. So I spoke with the store manager and asked her what percentage of goods that were sold in the store were manufactured by Canadians. She had absolutely no idea, and it had never been anything she ever concerned herself with. And she absolutely did not care. I told her that I walked all through the store and could not find any products with Made in Canada labels. I asked her if she could show me any. She could not because she had no idea what, if any, products were actually made in Canada. I then said to her that the sign on the wall was absolutely deceptive. China is a country that has no human rights and people work for slaves' wages to produce those cheap goods we now buy. As a result, our own manufacturing facilities have ceased and all the factories and equipment have been bought for nothing and shipped out to China. I heard somewhere that the poor peasants in China have to work 7 days a week every day of the year, with no holidays or days off. If a worker gets sick, they lose their job and may lose their life. As China has no public health care, China is a country with a huge population, where life is very cheap and people are very disposable. Anyone in China that dares to speak up soon discovers that reality. The same will soon be the case for all of us, as the New World Order masters will have it all. NAFTA is destroying our Canadian identity. The signs are everywhere. We will pay dearly for the loss of our manufacturing. Like all corporate takeovers, where they flood the market with cheap goods and destroy our self-sufficiency, the cheap goods will soon not be cheap. After we are completely dependent on cheap imported goods and can no longer make our own, they will raise the prices. Canada is a huge country with every conceivable natural resource. So can anyone tell me why there is a food bank where they give out free food to the starving in every neighborhood? Even the middle-class neighborhoods have food banks. Every city also now has soup kitchens where you can get a free meal once a day. It's because our wealth is being stolen and given to the executives in government and corporations. As long as the government workers are taken care of, they are very willing to ignore the situation. That is why government workers no longer respond to or care about the public's complaints or needs. Since NAFTA, my country's natural resources are being stolen by foreign corporate vultures. No longer is the value of our natural resources being shared with all Canadians. It is estimated that over 60% of Canada's employment is as a result of government spending. So we have 60% of the employed that are tax receivers, and there is only about 20% that are actually true taxpayers. The remaining are the many homeless, disabled, poor, sick, elderly, children, and the forgotten unemployed. The banksters are responsible for the destruction of our country. Canada's wealth has been diverted from the people's government to the banksters. Please read my Once Upon a Time There Was a Canada to get the whole story. The corrupt Federal Reserve systems are at the heart of all the world's problems. Please read my The Last Democracy to get the rest of the story. The out-of-control corporate criminals are proving that my grandmother was right when she told me some 35 years ago that too much of a good thing is never good. Will the banksters have it too good? The huge corporations have been created as a result of the banksters being able to provide the funds because they produce money out of thin air. It's amazing how free money can corrupt everything. It's a pyramid scheme. And the corruption has trickled down from the top and is now corrupting the very foundations of civilization. We have entered a new dark ages where the light of truth is extinguished. I am afraid that without truth we only get insanity, from the insanity of Monsanto's tampering with genetics, to unrestrained molecular tampering. That the unrestrained out-of-control insane are dooming this planet. Please read my, Are You Ready for the Truth? But I have to warn you. It is a very serious article and may really upset you. And please do not take the easy way out and think of attacking the messenger. Do your own research and you will eventually find out that everything I have written is backed up with the scary proof. Only the brave seek truth, all others are just cowards. Thanks to the digital age, the New World Order masters are attacking individual rights and liberties from every direction at the same time. The situation is so absolutely horrible that every caring informed individual has to become a truth soldier. And finally, please read my Corrupt Canadian Elections to learn how the digital age has made it so easy to fix vote results and completely subvert democracy and our ability to stop the New World Order's takeover of our future. Your silence of the horrible truth of their deceptions will guarantee the New World Order's success. For they thrive on secrecy. So do you think it just might be time to start screaming for your very life? While you still have a breath? But I fear that the corporate media's hold on your thoughts of reality will make our survival and individual freedoms impossible. Also learn about the machinations of the New World Order's depopulation agenda that is well underway. From the poison fluoride to the United States patented AIDS virus, and the FDA blocking literal one of the known cures for cancer. Is this the end? A Truth Soldier copyright notice. You are free to republish Truth Soldier and or Daniel J. Towsey articles in whole form only. You may take quotes from it as long as you provide a link back to the original article and you give attribution to the writer. Being a Truth Soldier, you are also free to print or email it in whole, only exception being corporations not allowed.